Welcome to this new tutorial of the series Data Mining Concepts and Techniques. Today we will see classification by backpropagation. So this is one of the important classification technique. So let's get started. Classification by backpropagation. It is a classification that is a mathematical mapping model. Classification means what? It predicts categorical class labels. For example, personal homepage classification, where xi is equal to x1, x2, x3 up to so on, and yi is equal to plus 1 or minus 1. X1 is here the hash of word homepage, and x2 is hash of word welcome. So mathematically, small x belongs to capital X, and we want a function f of x to y. Okay, so these textual format data we have represented into a mathematical form. So next is the linear classification, where binary classification problem is there. The diagram suggests the linear classification where there is a line, okay, which separate two classes. Okay, the data above the red line belongs to class X, and the data below red line belongs to class O. Okay, example of these linear classifications are SVM, perceptron, probabilistic classifier, so on. So this is the simple technique, linear classification. Then the next is discriminative classifier. The advantages of discriminative classifiers are prediction accuracy is generally high as compared to Bayesian methods in general, and it is robust, works when training example contains errors. So the special case for the discriminative classifiers are when the training contains error, then the discriminative classifier work well, or it is robust. And fast evaluation of the learn target function. Okay, where the Bayesian networks are normally slow. So these are some of the advantages of discriminative classifiers. And the criticism points for the discriminative classifiers are it takes long training time, and it is difficult to understand the learn functions, that is weights, as compared to Bayesian network. Bayesian networks can be used easily for pattern discovery, and it is not easy to incorporate domain knowledge, where easy in the form of priors on the data or distribution. So these are some of the criticism points for the discriminative classifier. So this is the diagram for perceptron and Vino. Okay, so here we update W additively in perceptron, and in Vino we update W multiplicatively. So this is one of the diagram. Then the classification by backpropagation. This is very important. A backpropagation means what? A neural network learning algorithm. It is a neural network algorithm, basically started by the psychologist and neurobiologist to develop and test computational analogies of neurons. Okay, so it is basically used by the psychologist and neurobiologist. Okay, a neural network, it is a set of connected input and output units where each connection has a weight associated with it. So the weight is important in neural network. Okay, and input and output units are connected. During the learning phase, the network learns by adjusting the weights so as to be able to predict the correct class label of the input tuples. So here the important term is the network learns by adjusting the weights. So weights, it is also referred to as a connectionist learning due to the connections between units. Okay, the next important is the neural network as a classifier. So there are the weaknesses and there are some of the strengths. Okay, for neural network as a classifier, first we will see the weaknesses. So neural network as a classifier takes long training time. So it takes long training time. This is the first weakness. Then it requires a number of parameters typically best determined empirically. So for example, the network topology or a structure. So the second weakness is it requires number of parameters. Then the third is poor interpretability. Okay. So what is that? It's difficult to interpret the symbolic meaning behind the learned weights and of hidden units in the network. Okay, so these are the three weaknesses for neural network as a classifier: long-term training time, then second is it requires a number of parameters, and third is poor interpretability. Okay, then there are some of the important strengths. So what are that strengths? The high tolerance to noisy data, then the ability to classify untrained patterns, then well suited for continuous valued inputs and outputs. Then the fourth is successful on a wide array of real world data. Fifth is algorithms are inherently parallel. And sixth is and last is techniques have recently been developed for extraction of rules from trained neural networks. So these are six strengths for the neural network as a classifier, and these are self-explanatory, so I will not go into the detail here. So the next is a neuron, or what is a perceptron. So basically a neuron or perceptron has a input vector as x, and which has applied the weight vector w on these input vectors, and it has a weighted sum. Then we apply activation function on this input and weight vectors, so to get the desired output y. Okay, this is the neuron or perceptron. Okay, here point to remember is the input vector, the weight vector, then we have the activation functions, and then we will produce the output based on that. Similarly, the multilayer feedforward neural network is there. The difference here is there is a multilayer. So in this single neuron or this network, there is an input vector and there is a hidden layer and output vector is there. But in multilayer, there is input vector associated with input layer, which has a hidden layer associated, and the output vector is associated with output layer, which has a hidden layer. So this is the multilayer feedforward neural network. Okay. So how it works, we will not go into the detail. Okay. The next is defining a network topology. So first decide the network topology, that is the hash of units in the input layer and hash of hidden layers. And if it is greater than 1, then hash of units in each hidden layer and hash of units in output layer is decided. So that is the network topology which we have to decide first. Then we will normalize the input values, okay, between 0 to 1. Then we will take the one input unit per domain value and each initialize to 0. And the output, if for classification and more than the two classes, one input or output per class is used. Okay, so the once the network has been trained and its accuracy is unacceptable, repeat the training process with a different network topology or a different set of initial weights. So if we train that network and we found that the accuracy not proper, then we will unaccept that accuracy and repeat the training process, okay, with a different network topology basically, to get a different output or to get the different accuracy or for improving the accuracy. So the important part here is the back propagation. So how it exactly works? First, it is a iteratively process. Okay, many times it repeats. Okay, so it is a iteratively process. A set of training tuples and compare the network prediction with the actual known target value. First step is to compare the network prediction with the actual known target value. Okay. Then for each training tuple, the weights are modified to minimize the mean squared error between the network prediction and the actual target value. Then it checks the error. Okay. And it is the weights are modified to minimize the error. Okay. Then next step is modifications are made in the backward direction. Okay. From the output layer to the hidden layer. So this process is called as a back propagation basically. Okay. How it works or the steps are given here. First initialize the weight. Okay. And biases in the network, then propagate the input forward. That is applying the activation function, then back propagate the error, okay, by updating the weights and biases. So weights are important here. Then the termination condition is when error is very small. Then the back propagation and interpretability, the efficiency of back propagation. Okay, it is basically minimizing the error. Then the rule extraction from networks. What is that? It is basically a network pruning where it simplifies the network structure by removing weighted links that have the least effect on the training network. So in the network structure, there are some weights which has the least effect on the training network and there are some weights which has the greater effect. So in the first step, we will remove the weights which has the least effect on the trained network. Then we perform link, okay, unit or activation value clustering, and then the set of input and activation values are studied to derive rules describing the relationship between the input and hidden unit layers. Okay, so these are the rule extraction from networks. Then the sensitivity analysis we will do in this part, okay, to get the desired output. So this is all about the back propagation basically. Okay, it is one of the important technique in the classification. Okay, do like, comment and share this video to your friends, and if you are new to the channel, subscribe to channel and press the bell icon for latest updates. Keep learning, keep watching. Thank you. Jai Hind.